My name is Howard Berry. I'm the father of the late Staff Sergeant Joshua Berry. My son died of wounds that were sustained during the first Fort Hood shooting. You won't find Josh listed among the killed or wounded. He didn't exist. The Army forgot about him. I'd like to take a moment to share some of the experiences and thoughts that I've had regarding my dealings with the United States Senate since my son's passing. To date, I've written all 100 senators. I've traveled to D.C. on two different occasions, spending a total of 3 weeks soliciting support for the victims and their families. I've asked each senator to please co-sponsor Senate Bill 1500, honoring the Fort Hood Heroes Act. The shooting was a terrorist act, and it's the right thing to do. Didn't these people volunteer to stand between us and our enemies? I don't understand. I don't understand because, you see, to date, no Democrats or independents have supported this legislation through co-sponsorship. When did this become a red team, blue team issue? And even more disturbing, the silence by majority of the Republicans. Do you condone this type of behavior? Why can't you stand up for the truth and represent the people that elected you? I don't understand. Men and women from 23 different states were killed or wounded, yet only 8 senators representing those folks stood up for them. New York, no support. New Jersey, no support. Maryland, no support. Virginia, no support. North Carolina, thank you, Senator Burr. Florida, thank you, Senator Rubio. Alabama, thank you, Senator Sessions. Tennessee, no support. Ohio, thank you, Senator Portman. Michigan, no support. Wisconsin, thank you, Senator Johnson. North Dakota, no support. Minnesota, no support. Indiana, no support. Illinois, no support. Iowa, no support. Missouri, no support. Oklahoma, thank you, Senator Coburn. Texas, thank you, Senator Cornyn. Thank you, Senator Cruz. Utah, no support. California, no support. Oregon, no support. Idaho, no support. How can you turn your back on your own constituents? And support for this bill, it made all of you look good. I don't understand. The men and women affected, their families forever changed, deserve to have the truth told. And you can't even do that. You know, the shooter was in contact with Al-Qaeda elements in North Africa. For those of you that don't remember Anwar al-Awlaki, We thought enough of him that we took him out with a drone strike. Nadal Hassan was in contact with him. Since his conviction, the shooters petitioned the leaders of ISIS, of the Islamic State, to grant him citizenship in the caliphate. And he just wrote a 6-page letter to the Pope, clearly stating that he's a soldier of Allah. Why can't you guys connect the dots? I am very grateful that our men and women in uniform fight better than you lead. I'm also very grateful that this is an election year. I am hoping that some of you have opportunities outside the Beltway after the first of the year, because you clearly don't stand up for the people that elected you. For those of you that are continuing to wear American flag pins on your lapels and have not supported these folks, please take them off. You dishonor them. I hope and pray that the good people in this country start to ask the right questions. Why aren't you supporting the troops? Why didn't you stand up for these people? Why aren't you taking action? I haven't met one person who's willing to lead from the front. It's very sad. I understand why the approval rating for Congress and the Senate is so low. Bill after bill after bill just sits there. H.R. 3111, Honoring the Fort Hood Heroes Act, mirrors Senate Bill 1500. 225 co-sponsors, a majority in the House. They're not going to vote on it, because you're not going to do your job. I hope and pray that there's some change coming in this country, because we can't keep going on like this. We're better people. God bless. I miss my son.